subscribe to my channel Your Tech Bro and hit the bell icon to get the instant notifications about the tech as soon as we upload.
Hey, hi guys, this is Dhanushekaran back here, and it's been 4 days since I have unboxed the Samsung Galaxy C7 Pro, as you guys might have seen it. For those who have not seen my unboxing video, check the descriptions over there. And it's been 4 days. I'm using the device for 4 days. I think I have just gained a bit of knowledge about that device. So in this video, we'll be seeing in-depth review of the Samsung Galaxy C7 Pro. So without further delays, let's get started. And well guys, this is the C7 Pro itself, as you can see here. And this device works in a pretty good conditions. On all odds, this device works in an excellent way. And as usual, I've just divided this video into pros and the cons. And for those buyers who need to buy this mobile, I just leave it to you. You can decide on yourself, is this mobile suitable for you or not. And let's get started. For first, let's go on for the pros itself. And I should say the display quality of this device is very good. It is being powered by 5.7 inch Super AMOLED display, and Super AMOLED display is not being present in most of the budget oriented device. And well, I should say that this device is cost around 23,990, that is around 24,000 Indian money. And this is neither a flagship nor a budget oriented mobile. This is this sort of a mid-range, I should say. It has an always on display on its screen. That is a good turnover from Samsung. Well, the display is very good. It has auto brightness, and brightness is very good. In all conditions, you are able to see the screen itself. Yeah, you have a mono speaker at the bottom, very bottom. And one more thing, the receiver here will also act as a dual secondary speaker. But the output of this earpiece is not so good, but it somehow manages it to give a dual speaker sound. That is a great advantage in this device. And another important thing is that you can disable this secondary speaker from the settings itself. And let's move on to be the next one. It is powered by 3300 milliamps battery, and sort of average using this device comes up for a day and a half. And I've just used this device for surfing a lot and playing high-end games. And for me, it gives a decent battery life, about one single day. And the next is this device has an active fingerprint sensor. Why do I say active fingerprint sensor? Because I use Samsung Galaxy S7 Edge as my daily usage mobile. The fingerprint sensor in this, as you guys know, I have to press either a power button or the home key to activate my to unlock my device. But in this device, you can see here, it just unlocks without pressing your home key or your power key. And this device is cost around 56,000, and this just cost around 23,000. Look at the difference and Samsung has made in this. And also the fingerprint speed in this device is being a lot improved from the previous generation of C7 to the C7 Pro. It has been improved a lot. Yeah, the build quality of this device, I should say, this build quality is very excellent in this device. As soon as I unbox this device, holding the phone on my hand for the first time, it just took me to the next level of experiencing a smartphone. And look at the design, guys. It's so slim and sleek that Samsung has given in this device. So good to hold this mobile in hand, and so premium to hold this device. It's sort of prestigious to hold this mobile, as the outer is having an aluminium metal body, which gives a sort of a premium look for this device. We have to speak about the sensors. Samsung has added a lot of sensors in this device for a mid-range mobile. Usually Samsung will not issue some of the most important sensors on their budget oriented device, but this is not the case. You have all the sensors in this device. Let it be the auto brightness, let it be the ambient sensor, or the gyroscope, proximity, everything you have in this device. Yes, the next process, RAM management. As this device is powered by a 4GB of RAM, this device is good at RAM management. I just do a lot of multitasking in my devices. I don't feel any slugs, any sort of lags in this device during multitasking. Multitasking is very good in this device, as you can see right now. And I just opened tons of apps here. As you can see, there are no sort of lags here. It just runs very smoothly. And then let's move on for the gaming. If you're a sort of a heavy gamer, I do recommend this mobile to you, because I have run Asphalt 8 with highest settings being turned on, and I never face any lags in this device or any overheating in this device. Maximum temperature that this mobile touched while playing high-end games is about 38 degrees. But I didn't face any of the heating issues in this device. I can easily recommend this device for all sort of gamers, for all type of gaming. Okay guys, let's just move on for the cons of this device. There are nothing much cons in this device, but there are some few cons being listed that I face using this device on a regular basis. The first one would be the camera. This device is powered by 16 megapixel front and rear facing shooter, and the pictures being shot in the rear facing shooter are sort of below average. It's not average also, it's a below average. The pictures come out to be much contrast than the clarity. The clarity is being less here, but the contrast is being high here. I've changed to all the settings, but for all the settings, the pictures shot in these images are the same. Contrast is high, quality is less. Coming on to the indoor lighting conditions. Indoor lighting conditions that's disappointed me a lot. It's just bad quality of images this mobile gives in the indoor lighting conditions. The picture comes up to be not a bit, but huge noise in the images. I don't know, Samsung may improve this on its next update. Let's go on for the next one. This device captures a poor audio quality while you just take your videos via your front facing shooter. If you are just a vlogger, I certainly do not recommend this device for you, because the audio clarity from the microphone, built-in microphone in this device, or if it's being connected to any of the external mic. I just connected my Boya mic, as you see here on my collar, which is being right now. I just connected that mic over this device. Even though the audio pickup in this device is very less, and it's very poor also. So for vloggers, this mobile is not for you. Let's go on for the next cons. The biggest flaws in this device is this device doesn't support any video stabilization, like electronic image stabilization or the optical image stabilization that should be present. Even nowadays, these image stabilizations are being present in budget-oriented phones around 10 to 15,000, but this is being caused more than 20,000. Certainly, I had expected any sort of image stabilization, but no such image stabilization is being present in this device. And the next cons is it has a poor audio quality. The audio output from this device via your earphones just give a bitter experience. For the guys, those who are listening music for a long time via your earphones, I certainly do not recommend this mobile for you, because it just gives a very certainly low amount of audio output from this device. Still, this device is running in Android Marshmallow 6.0.1, and this is very sad to say, and I don't know whether this device will be getting Android 7.0 or not, because C9 Pro has already got Android 7.0 Nougat update. I don't know, but I think you will get the update. Wait for it.